Hey y'all, today has been a long day. We had our appointment with Charlie's psychologist, and I will probably, yeah, what's up, baby? Yeah, go put them in your closet, okay? I'll probably do a video update on that when the time is right. I do want to be open and helpful with you guys that might be going through the same things, and use this channel not only to build memories but to also be helpful and relatable to other people who might be going through some stuff. Yeah, baby.
Mom, you know I got work to do.
You got work to do?
Yeah.
Show the viewers your overalls.
Look, guys. You take it off.
Yeah, let Daddy do it, and I'll be in there in a minute, okay? Yeah, so I'll probably do a video update on how the appointment went, and just kind of let you guys know all about that, but it'll probably be later on after we've kind of had a few more appointments and some time to process everything. But we have some other news to talk about in this video that's pretty exciting and positive and joyful. We have a new member of the family. And since he's kind of hard to video at the moment, he or she, I will insert a picture right here. So yeah, we got an axolotl. And we didn't really know too much when we got it, but I've been doing extensive research, and if any of you guys know anything about it, tell me. But we are about to get his or her. We really have to come up with a gender neutral name because we really won't know its gender until about a year old. But yeah, we're about to set up his tank, so join us. Basically, what is happening is Wildcat, our red beta, is going to be moved to a smaller fishbowl since he really doesn't swim around that much and he really doesn't need that large of a space. So yeah, he will be moved to the fishbowl, and the axolotl will be getting the 10-gallon tank because it is recommended 10-gallon tank for one adult axolotl. If you have, sometimes you need a 20-gallon long tank, but for now our 10-gallon will do because he's really small. So yeah, we're gonna set up the beta tank, what used to be the beta tank, to be the axolotl's new. So one thing that we learned after getting our new axolotl friend is that they need filtration for their tank. Because they're quite messy, they poop a lot, they're pooping machines apparently. Don't know yet, don't have any experience. But however, they do need a good filter, but they do not like hard currents in their tank. They like smooth water. They don't like, okay, you know, for people that really don't know what I'm talking about, when the water comes down out of the filter, it creates like a hard rush of water because the filter can be so powerful. Well, they don't like that. They like for their water to be smooth and not have currents and everything. So a lot of people recommend certain kinds of filters. A lot of people use sponge filters. I went to the Petco in our town and they did not have any, so I ended up with this Fluval Aqua Clear power filter. And if you see right there, it has this little notch that you can up the speed of the water coming out or you can slow it down. So yeah, I hear a lot of good things about these with the 3-step filtration system. So yeah, that's what we ended up getting. And Austin is rocking Olivia right now, so I'm just kind of doing what I can until she goes to sleep and we can both work on getting the axolotl's tank set up. Okay, so I got Mr. Wildcat out of his tank. He's hanging out in his poor little beta cup, just chilling right now. We're gonna clean out this tank
try to get it all set up.
I've got all the water drained out of the tank.
Now, Austin, he just caught the axolotl and put him back in his cup that he came in. And we'll get the betta good to go in his bowl. Do you want to just go dump that in the bathroom too? We're going to see how much rocks the betta needs from the tank. Okay, we've just about got Mr. Wildcat all set up here. I'm just letting him hang out in his old water to kind of get the temperature right and get him settled in without freaking him out over the temperature. Yeah, I have been wanting a betta to put in me and Austin's master bedroom for a while now because I've just enjoyed Mr. Wildcat so much. And this way Austin gets out of it, not having to buy a second betta. He was like, oh, well, we don't have to buy a second betta because we can move Mr. Wildcat into our bedroom now. And our axolotl can go right there on the hallway table where Mr. Wildcat used to live. Smooth one, babe, smooth one. Okay, so we picked up this, this Crayola play sand from Walmart. It seems like it's pretty finely ground up sand. So yeah, I have a friend she's a friend that is a friend of my sister-in-law's. She actually has two axolotls and she's kind of been giving me pointers on what to use and how to care for these little guys. So yeah, this is one of the things she recommended. Okay, I'm about to start the dreaded filling process. I know that axolotls like places to hide, but I think I have a faux log at my mom and dad's house from when I used to have a Chinese water dragon. So I don't have that yet. I'm probably gonna run over there tomorrow and see if we still have it. So for now, I don't really have anything to pour the water on top of. Normally I would pour the water on top, straight on top of the log so that it didn't stir up the sand so much, but I had seen where people recommended just putting a paper plate in the tank and pouring it on the paper plate so that it doesn't stir the sand up. We'll see how that works. I don't know. We just put a plastic plate down because we don't buy paper plates, because paper plates are not good for the environment. So yeah, anyways, I'm not gonna go on around about that. So let's go. Booger isn't asleep yet and she was getting upset, so daddy's gonna have to fill it the rest of the way. But this is how it's done so far. The plate idea has worked great. Look how clear the water is. It's not crazy at all. Almost full though, maybe just a little bit more so that the filter can reach. I'm about to go set up the filter.
Too drunk to talk right now. You put your cigarette I hold my face so beautiful. Please, woman, don't break your back for me. I'll put you out of your misery. Tell me that it's all okay. I've been waiting on it so.
Y'all, I'm so excited.
Mommy.
Yeah? Just a minute. Here it is. All put together. I'm going to have a log for the axolotl to hide under. They like hiding spots. And I have the pump going full blast right now. Just until he gets in there, he or she. Just to kind of circulate the water through. Good night, buddy.
No.
Sleep good. But here is the little lever. If you see, I pull it down and it changes the water flow to really slow. That's what they like. I'll probably keep it somewhere in the middle, though. But you can also have it going full blast, which, like I said, that's what I'm doing for now. Got this pretty soft silk plant. So it doesn't hurt it or anything. And yeah, I'll just let that filter through for a while. And there's the lid, because I've heard that sometimes they jump out. And Austin would have to catch it.
What if you were here without me?
I'm not sure. Charlie's currently having a breakdown because something must have happened with his TV. But yeah, there it is, and I'm so excited to see the axolotl in there. I think I see a rock. They cannot have rocks or gravel because they have a strong suction when they eat, and they'll suck up gravel and it will cause impaction. So that's why we got rid of the gravel. So yeah, super excited, and Mr. Wildcat is about ready to go in his new cozy home.
Susie.
Okay, Mr. Wildcat is in there and happy. I have my axolotl in his tank. And he is floating, trying to get used to the water temperature. Okay. Hey, hold it up and let me get a good shot of it up close first. Okay, ready to go to its new home. It'll be much happier. Probably won't know what to think with all that room.
Should I try and feed it?
Yeah, I would. Yay!
Should I try and feed it again? She just couldn't talk. Or it. You see that?
Ah, he's sitting on you.
Whoa.
What?
Feels weird.
Does he?
Yeah, when he moves, like, you can't really feel his little hands. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to touch you. I'm just trying to make sure you're full.
Okay. All together and set up. With the lid on top. And he's chilling in his new place. Probably gonna move the silk plant over here to kind of help
with the flow later and put his hiding log over here. Or her. I keep saying his. Don't really know if it's a him or her. And we have still yet to pick a name. So if you guys have a suggestion for a name, a gender neutral name, please comment down below.